Monarchs face many dangers on their trip south, and they still face obstacles even after reaching their destination. Overnight temperatures can drop below freezing, and snow may even fall during their stay in Mexico. Fortunately, since monarchs are a cold-blooded insect, they don't require much energy in cold temperatures, and they will eat very little in order to save their food reserves. They can only fly in temperatures of at least 55 degrees Fahrenheit. During January and early February, many monarchs can die due to low temperatures that dip below 17 degrees Fahrenheit. 50% of monarchs won't survive in these conditions, and only 10 to 20% will survive if they become wet.
There's been a documented decline in overwintering populations in Mexico. If the coverage of Mexico gets down to a certain area, that was equivalent to quasi-extinction. According to those models, we were very close to potentially losing this migration phenomenon. And there's weather events such as bad ice storms that have killed off a lot of the monarchs in Mexico.
Temperatures that are too warm can be dangerous as well. In their dormant state, monarchs can retain the nutrients they need to survive. But warmer weather can cause them to burn through their food reserves too quickly.
That can be bad because they'll find themselves too far north. They'll outrun their food resource. Cooler weather ahead of the monarchs as they get into southern Texas is good because that keeps the monarchs there in southern Texas where the milkweed has emerged and grown up.
Luckily, the Oyamo forests in Mexico can protect the monarchs from sharp temperature changes by acting like a blanket. If the forest is thinned or cut down, the monarchs won't be protected. Monarch butterflies face even more hazards when migrating. Luckily, the monarch has developed a potentially deadly defense to discourage hungry hunters. The milkweed that sustains the caterpillars contains toxins which makes their skin toxic and unpleasant to taste. Scientists theorize this may be the reason the viceroy butterfly so closely resembles the monarch. The viceroy is a slightly smaller butterfly, and if you look closely, you will see a telltale black line running along the bottom of the viceroy's wings that isn't present on the monarch. The similarity might be just enough to confuse predators that have learned to avoid eating the foul-tasting monarchs. But this defense is not a perfect solution, as predators like the praying mantis can withstand the toxins or can avoid eating the butterfly's skin.
There you go. There's that milky stuff. It's almost like a glue. It's poisonous. That's why the caterpillars, when they eat that inside their bodies, then it's a defense mechanism. It helps them. A bird or something might eat one of the caterpillars, but it probably won't eat one again.
The weather poses an even greater danger. Wind and rain can prevent the monarchs from flying and force them to shelter in trees. In 2002, a rainstorm combined with low temperatures killed an estimated 250 million monarchs in Mexico. Because the tree cover is so vital for migrating butterflies, deforestation can be deadly for the monarchs that need the forest to survive stormy conditions.
One of the things that we're trying to do with our education programs is to recognize that by planting just a few milkweed plants in your front yard, you're helping those monarchs on their journeys as they migrate or and as part of their life cycle. That can really have a large impact. The fate of the monarch butterfly is like the canary in the coal mine for us as a human species. If we can't take care of our fellow beings on this planet, and we can't help and we can't live with them, we're not going to be able to live here either.